So ladies and gents, let's meet the contestants in fighting out of the blue corner. His record stands at 19 contests, 11 wins and 8 defeats. He weighed in at 9.3 pounds and 14 ounces. And he comes from the city of La Chopera in Panama. Ladies and gentlemen, a big welcome for Ari Aguiles. And standing opposite in the red corner. His record stands at 25 contests, 25 wins, 7 cycle distance, and just 3 defeats. He weighs in at 9.3 pounds and 14 ounces and wears the blue with the Union flag now in the pants of his shorts. He comes from the city of Liverpool, ladies and gentlemen, Jazza Dickens. This is 6 3-minute rounds in the Super Featherweight Division. Your referee will be finally switching.
Don't let anything low, watch your head, stay great, take a step, most important, things
have got
time.
Okay, here we go, Black Flash Promotions show from Bowlers in Manchester. The show is sponsored by BritishBoxers.co.uk, Andrew Cowley Construction, Lean and Clean and RDX. I'm joined in the commentary position by two Colliers and Moston lads, Tommy Fury, Sean Ben Mulligan. We've got Jazza Dickens, a former British champion, in the ring now against Barney Aguilas in a super featherweight contest. And Jazza is looking ready.
Yeah, definitely, he's looking sharp. Made a fast start. Looking forward to seeing Jazza tonight. Obviously, he's not boxed for a little while, has he? So good to see him back in here.
Now, he's got a British title looming, so he doesn't want to do anything silly in here, you know, pick up any cuts or nicks or anything like that, does he? How does he go about winning the fight, but sort of staying out of the danger zone, so to speak, lads?
Of course, yeah, obviously, like you say, it's sort of like a warm-up fight for his British title fight, innit? But this kid here, obviously, knows what he's doing. He's no mug, is he? So he's just got to get in here, obviously, because he's been out of the ring for a while as well. Just get the rounds, probably good. The better if you can get the rounds, it's a 4-round off, so yep. Just get the rounds in and obviously, you know, get himself back in there for obviously before his British title fight with Ward.
Well, Jazza is a lightning fast southpaw. Lads, how do you adjust when you're fighting a southpaw in the ring? I mean, both of you have fought southpaws. How do you adjust?
Yeah, obviously you always say with a southpaw when you're orthodox, you know, move to your left out of the way of that backhand. But you know, this kid here, he's not just south, but he's a lot taller than Jazza as well, so probably a little bit awkward. Jazza, I think, just needs to close the distance, do what he's doing, and I think he'll get to him, obviously.
Good counter right
hand there. Very good shot. Yeah.
Nice little whipping counter right hand off the lead hand there. Tommy, I know you've been looking forward to seeing Jazza in the ring, haven't you?
Yeah, it's the first time seeing him up close and live, so he's lightning fast. He has got tremendous speed, and he moves well around the ring. Good ring craft. Evading shots nicely.
And of course, he's got a bit of a Liverpool legend in Derry Matthews in his corner, a fighting man himself. You know, he never ducked anyone. Jazza's sort of cut from that same cloth. You know, he'll fight anyone. He's got the rematch with Ward lined up as well. And he's looking today just to, you know, exhibit some of his skills.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, as you say, he's fought one of the best in Regan Dow, so he's got that experience there with him. And as I say, this is just like Ben said, all-up fight, so he doesn't want to slip up here. He wants to keep it nice and tight and do the business.
And this Aguilas doesn't look like he's coming to lie down. He's picking some nice counters himself. And just as I say that, Jazza is walking him into the ropes, but, you know, he's not come to lie down, has he?
Definitely not. He looks very serious in his work. He needs to be careful, Jazza. He needs to keep his hands up tight. That's better, though.
Jazza imposing himself here with some good hooks. He's got his man pinned against the ropes here. Benny, do you like what you're seeing?
Yeah, definitely. He's picking it up now, Jazza, in there. Getting to the end of the round there. Obviously, he was coming on top, so just needs to keep doing what he's doing. Keep hitting that body. Obviously, with this kid being a lot taller as well. Getting close, cutting the range, hitting the body. Oh, we could see Jazza get him out of here.
Seconds out. Round two.
Okay, here we go, round number two. The first one was a lively one. Here we go, starting off round number two, and Jazza holding the centre of the ring.
I think Jazza just needs to keep carry on doing what he's doing. Obviously, he's finding his range now.
Yeah, that was a beautiful jab there.
Yeah.
He's a very dedicated man, Jazza. We've been up to see him training. He takes it very seriously. He's focused and, you know, he's hoping to get back up to British title level and beyond.
Yeah, of course. Like I say, he lives a life, doesn't he? And he's very, very talented. He's a very good amateur as well. I remember him in the amateurs. And obviously, he wants that British title back, doesn't he? So, you know, this is just a fight that's, you know, a warm-up fight as such, but no fight's an easy fight, is it? So, you see, obviously, he's took it seriously, like any fight.
He's picking some beautiful shots now. He just threw a raking straight left hand, straight down the pipe, a bit like how Pacquiao throws it. He's picked some nice right hooks off the lead arm. Tommy, are you impressed with what you see?
Yeah, very impressed there. That was a lovely straight left hand down the pipe. And his opponent did well to stand up to it, to be honest. But he definitely hasn't come to lie down, you can see that.
Took a couple of body shots back there, Jazza, but, you know, he's that well conditioned that it didn't seem to faze him.
No, you can see by the shape of him, he's in very good shape. And he's throwing some nice combinations. Good pressure.
Oh, he's very effective when he's got his man to the back with the back to ropes, you know, winging in these body shots.
Yeah,
mixing
definitely.
It up with straight shots down the middle.
He's in your face and he's creating good angles there. Lovely boxing.
It's a real handful. He's throwing back, he's trying to meet fire with fire. He's just a little bit outgunned at the minute. Beautiful body shot.
Yeah, therefore, you see the levels now, can't you? Obviously, Jazza there making him miss, stepping round and then throwing them shots. You see, obviously, he had that British title. He's probably ready. If he wins that British title, he's ready to go on. Then above domestic level, he's looking class now.
Just in a little bit of a change in the tempo. Jazza just on the back foot a little bit more, but he's done well to evade a lot of shots there, and he comes back with his own now.
Yeah, he's mixing it up, and he's, like I say, he's put the pressure on him then, and then he's gone on the back foot now, probably just bringing the kid onto the shots now, but he's winning around very comfortably anyway. Lovely.
Nice combination body to head there.
Yeah, the body shots are
entertaining early. Rounds.
Seconds out. Round three.
Okay, here we go, round number three. We've got Jazza Dickens in there, former British champion, and Barney Aguilas. I'm joining the commentary positions by Tommy Fury and Sean Ben Mulligan from Collier's and Austin Boxing Gym. And Tommy, a lot of people talk about walking your man onto shots. What do they mean when they actually talk about walking your man onto shots?
It's just like throwing your feints on there, not moving back in straight lines, giving him lots of things to think about. And then, oh, that was a nice uppercut there.
Picked that beautifully.
That was a lovely uppercut.
Yeah.
Lovely movement there.
Lovely movement there. Spinning off at angles. I love to see that.
I like the way he's twisting to body shots. A tough guy, though.
He is, but Jazza's effectively managing to smother the other guy's work, isn't he? I mean, he's cramping him for room. I mean, Barney's got some long levers, and he's cramping him for room, which is a good tactic.
Yeah, definitely. He's got a lot of pressure. He's giving a lot of pressure here. He's a good pressure fighter.
Well, he tried the Lomachenko there, bringing the guard down and throwing the shot over the top.
Yeah. Jazza Dickens would be an awkward man for anybody. He's a fast southpaw who gives angles, and that is, you know, anybody will find that hard. Oh.
And Benny, what do you make of this change in tactics? He's come out here and he's looked to close the range a little bit, hasn't he?
Yeah, definitely. I heard him dead in his corner there saying what the work rate now, you know, twos and threes, so you see he's sniffing a rat now. He knows that he can get him out of here probably, can't he? So I think he just don't be too reckless, keep changing the angles like he's doing, and I think he'll get him out of here. But the kid's tough, he's no walkover.
He's setting a relentless pace, is Jazza.
Yeah, like
he's
you
not
say,
letting his man settle, is he?
No, definitely not. And like you say, he's a 12-round fighter, Jazza, isn't he? He's class, so, you know, with it being a four round though, he knows that he can fight at a relentless pace, which we're seeing here now.
Starting to make Barney miss a bit here as well, which is a sign of a class fighter.
Definitely, yeah, therefore. You know, we know he's got a great offense, but you know, his defense looks solid tonight. He's making him miss, taking shots on the arms, countering, so yeah, boxing very well.
And Tommy, they say a good defence sort of sets everything up, and you know, do you go by that sort of ethos that, you know, defence is the key to offence?
Yeah, definitely. As I've been learning the gym, Pat and Paul have been telling me every day, defence is the key. Paul told me this morning, offence is natural, defence is not, so you need to learn the defence, and then that will automatically blow people onto big shots. If you can push a man back with just your defence, it will break his heart. If he's throwing everything he's got and he's just landing on the gloves and arms, he's going to get disheartened.
Well, what I like about Jazzer here is he's actually bullying the taller and bigger man,
yeah,
around
definitely.
The ring.
Definitely, size doesn't seem to be a factor in this fight, I'll tell you that.
And that night, Benny, you finished the fight with a beautiful spin-off, right hand over the top, and we're seeing a lot of those angles here from Jazzer as well, aren't we?
Yeah, definitely. Like I was just saying in that last round, as he was getting close and he was switching the angles, he was finding openings, because this kid's got a tight guard, hasn't he? So sometimes it's hard to get through, but I think once if he pressures him, like I say, switches the angles, I think he can get him out of here. But fourth and final round now, but like I said in the first round, it won't do him any harm getting a four round in, because obviously, you know, he needs the work done it before, obviously, his British title fight.
Yeah, but you know, Barney's come out here with a lot of ambition. He's actually, you know, his corner may have told him to sort of get on it now and try and take the fight to Jazza.
Therefore, yeah, he's no pushover, this kid, certainly. He's not a journeyman that's just coming out to just run and get paid and tie you up. He's having a go as well, isn't he? So, but obviously, that's what Jazza will want. Jazza don't want someone that's just going to stand there and do nothing, does he? So, mate, it's a good fight, do you know what I mean? You see Jazza there, quite with a good body shot.
And Tommy, we were talking before about the Lonsdale title being one of our favourite titles in boxing. I mean, you know, someone in your family, he's challenging Sam Sexton for the British title soon, isn't he?
Yeah, definitely. It's a very good comeback fight for him. It's a very good belt to win, you know, British title. You know, it's a lovely belt to have, and he goes down in history. So, and for Yui, that fight, be a good fight for him, good fight for the fans. And I see Yui stopping him in tight six rounds, to be honest.
Fair enough. And, you know, Jazza, I mean, at the minute, Jazza, he's looking British title level and more, really, isn't he? He's looking sharp, he's looking aggressive, he's looking a real, real handful.
Yeah, you can see domestic level, you know, guys like this, he'll deal with all day. There's some great fights out there for him.
Picked that shot beautifully, really did. Just waited for his opportunity and raked in that left hand straight down the pipe.
This fella is no mug, though. He is tough.
Yeah, he is. He's really sat down on that body shot as well.
Measuring up now for the right hand.
Look at that.
Good body shot.
The referee's having a good look. Could force a stoppage.
I've got to give it up to this Barney Aguilas. He's taken some real shots here, and he's not looking for the back door or the exit.
Yeah, defo, Jazz is sitting down on his shots now. You can hear them from sat here, them shots sinking into the body. So, like I say, this kid's very tough. He's definitely not here to lie down, is he? Levels, though. See the class from Jazz now.
Jazz is looking to finish him here, I think. Yeah, just as I say that, he wings in some combinations. He bulls him back into the ring with forearm control.
Seconds out. Round five.
Here we go, round five. Jazza Dickinson, former British champion, in there with Barney Aguilas. He's starting to take over the fight now, isn't he, boys?
Yeah, big time. I will be surprised if he goes six rounds, but like I say, the kid's tough, good shot there. Good head movement as well. I'm impressed tonight with Jazz's head movement, especially when he's in close. You can see he's looking through his eyes. You can see he's in control, he knows what's coming back. You can see he's practicing things as well, he's working on stuff, so. Good shot. Very good shot.
That's a nice shot around the corner. Turned that left hand in, didn't he? Really found the shot well there.
Lovely. See there, switching the angle.
Yeah, absolutely.
Creating openings.
Referee having a look at Barney. A great left hand. He's come to fight, though.
I don't know.
Derry's asking for four shots, and I think he's going to get them because Jazz is in the mood. This is good to watch.
Defoe looking to take him out now, Jazz off.
Now, Tommy, as you're sort of having a purple patch like this, do you also need to be careful that you're not punching yourself out?
Yeah, I mean, you can see by shape he's fit, and it's only a four rounder, so. Is this a rash round?
Oh, no, it's a six rounder, yeah, it's a six rounder.
Oh, it's a six rounder?
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, that was a big shot. Yeah, he's very fit, kid. I don't think there's any problems in his gas tank. Oh! Oh, dear God.
I'm telling you, from ringside, you can feel these shots winging in.
He's giving it in. All credit to Barney's opponent, though. All credit.
Oh, yeah. Got to respect a guy who can take shots like this and stay in there and not look for a way out.
He's game.
He is game, but he's taking a lot of shots here now, body and head. Referee's having a lot. I mean, Barney's complaining, but I think that's a good stoppage because he's starting to take flurries and unanswered shots. And it's a great performance by Jazza Dickens there.
Yeah, quality and that. Great finish. Could see it coming at the start of the round, obviously. Like I say, that Barney's unbelievably tough. Some of the shots he took, I don't know how he didn't get him out of there early, but as you can see there, Jazza just levels above him, and hopefully now that'll put him in good stead to go and get that British title back.
Well, on a performance like that, I think Ward will be in for an... I mean, Ward, a class fighter himself, unbeaten, but I think on a performance like that, Jazza's going to give him an exceptionally difficult night's work.
Yeah, of course, yeah. Jazza looked class there. Obviously, he's made change, had a move with Jim's as well, hasn't he? So maybe that's done him good. Maybe he needed a bit of a change from the last fight, so... Nah, he looked very, very good, very impressed with him there.
Ladies and gents, a big hand for both fighters. Looking strong here at the Bowlers Exhibition Centre. And after 2 minutes and 24 seconds of round 5, your referee has stopped the contest with, in his opinion, not fit to continue. So your winner from Liverpool, Jazza Dickens!
Jazza Dickens takes the victory and moves on to his British title fight. Congratulations to Jazza. Been a pleasure, boys.
And ladies and gentlemen,
thanks, Zach. Yeah, really enjoyed that.
Bobani Alvarez.
We've got Jazza Dickens, we've got Derry Matthews with us as well, and Jazza, a really impressive, flashy fifth round stoppage there. Firstly, assess your performance for us, mate.
Yeah, it was good. It was nice to get in with Derry and George and, you know, try things out and things that we've worked in the gym, not just putting body shots, putting body and head, and that's where the stoppage came from, stuff that we had learned in the gym.
Now, your opponent there, give fair credit to him, he took some hard shots from you and he tried to make a fight of it, but there was levels and, you know, you were finding angles, finding hurtful shots.
Yeah, well, he's quite strong, to be honest. He was a lot bigger than me, Natalie, so... I felt a bit safer on the inside, and that's where I got the stoppage. I had to do what I had to do. Being long would be playing this game, but got close and worked him out.
Derry, at some point in that fight, did you tell Jazza to sort of close the range and work a bit more on the inside?
He told us what he wanted to do. I want him to just give a couple of foot back, sorry, a couple of inches back, sorry, and then just thought he'll get more shots off. But Jazza come back and said to me and George, he feels safe closer to him. He felt he was tired, and so. He knows more than us, he's in there with him. But from our point of view, I thought it was a brilliant performance. What we've been working on in the gym, stopping the bouncing, doing the little steps, being in control, saving your energy for the later rounds. we know what's next after this fight. He's got a British title fight, so, you know, we come out of here uninjured and he's ready to go. He's just waiting for the date now to become British champion, and I think that fight there has set him in good stead for a big title fight.
Absolutely, and Jazzy, you've got a great team, you know, George working with you, Derry working with you. You look super fit there. You know, obviously you can go the 12-round distance. Your fitness looked exemplary tonight. You set a very high work rate.
Yeah, they got me in good shape, as you can see, trying new things, and probably haven't seen a performance from me like that as of yet, so more to come.
British title fight up next, Jazza, and you know, I know you're itching to get your hands on that title and to move on as well to world honours.
Tommy Ward's got me belt and I want it back.
Jazza, absolutely brilliant speaking to you. Derry, thanks for joining us, and George as well. And Jazza Dickens, he moves on now to a British title fight. Make sure you tune in, because it's going to be a good one.